a semicolon and we have to stack the next attribute value. For example, color, right? Color, I want to give yellow, right? Close this. This is the what a statement we have used where in the CSS, right? This is a statement we have used in the CSS, right? I hope you guys will remember. In external, we have used the same thing, right? So H1 background color, then color is to yellow, something we have used, correct? For paragraph, we can use the same thing. But property, something like background, only text, we can use the color is to, this should be displaying green color, semicolon, then text align equal to, not equal to, you have to use your semicolon, colon. Then we can use the some center or right, left, we can use this one. This is what we have used, correct? So by seeing this, we can easily say that it start with some tags, H1, P, right? These are some of the tags, correct? So it start with the tags. So in CSS, the same tag, we will call it as what? Selectors. So in syntax, in HTML, in CSS syntax, first always be the selector, correct? H1, P, whatever the tags we say it as, like here, we say it as in HTML, say it as a tags or element. But when it comes to CSS, we say it as a selectors. So CSS syntax always starts with what? Selectors. Then forward with flower bracket. And this what? Background color, right? This value, what we have given here. This we say it as a property, correct? This we say it as a property. Property, okay? Background color, color, text align, this color, right? These are the, we say it as a property in the CSS. So selectors, open flower bracket and followed with the property, what we want to apply, right? What we want to apply, whether indicating for browser, you have to do the background color, right? You have to use this color. You have to use the text align. These are some of the properties, right? So these properties are predefined. I will explain each and everything, okay? Property. Then forward with colon. In HTML, we are using equal symbol, right? Equal symbol. There we are going to use for H1, right? Background color equals to something. We are going to use them with the equal symbol. But in CSS, we have to use with colon symbol. Okay, property, colon. These are what? Red, yellow, green, center. These are what? Value. That is property value. We are going to use the value here. Okay, and colon. Semicolon. Right. This we say it as a declaration. Right. We are giving for one particular selector, we are using the declaration. Right. What this will do? What will be the indication for the browser? Indication for the browser is that for this particular selector, you have to perform this task. Right. For this particular selector, you have to perform this tag. Right. Now, I want to apply one more property. Okay, I want to apply one more property for same selector as we have done here, right? H1. We have used two properties here. One is background color, other one is the color. Okay, I want to use one more property for the same selector. How to do that one? It should, first property should end with the semicolon, and second property, you have to use the property value. Property, same thing, and value. Right. This is what the syntax of the CSS. Selector, property value, then property value. If I'm giving multiple property for the same selector, it should, first after completing a first property, it should end with the semicolon. Then the second property should start. Correct? This is what the CSS syntax. Okay. And this we say it as a declaration. Okay. Only the first property we say it as. Okay, if we give the only one property for selector, that we say it as declaration. And second, we say it as a combination of both. How many properties we can apply for one particular selector, the whole property right? We say it has a what? Declaration block. Declaration block. Okay, in CSS syntax, it should start with a selector, right? Followed with property, then followed with value. Okay, this is one, only one property applying for selector means we're going to end the flower bracket here. If you want to apply the second property in the same selector, so use the semicolon and start with the other property value. Right, one property we set is a declaration. The combination of all the properties, what we are giving for the same selectors, that we set a declaration blocks. Right, this is the one example. Right, this we say it as a what? This is what? Declaration and the whole, both we say it as a declaration block. This is regarding the CSS syntax. Right, now what is the role of selectors? What is the role of selectors? As I said, selector means here H1, P rate, right? All those things we said are selectors. Why we need the selector? Right. It will say for the browser, it will tell for the browser, for this H1 means for this selector, you have first thing what you have to do. First it will set the property, background color. Okay, it will check background color. Okay, for this property means for this selector, I have to perform this property work. I have to perform this task, background color. Next, it will check the value, right? Background color, it got the the rule, right? For this H1, it should be a background color, should be, it should perform the background color, right? Next, value should, right? What color it should do for this H1, whether it is red, green, white, what it should do, the value should it should get, right, to perform that particular task. So next, it will check with the value, okay, red. So it will perform this property for this selector. Next it will check. Okay, it next will check the semicolon. Semicolon indicating that it's having one more work for the same selector. It will check color, then yellow. So what it will do? So whatever the text we have written for this H1, for example, H1, I have given the text like SVIT college. Okay, that SVIT college will be displaying yellow color. Displaying yellow color. So what the selectors will do? The selectors. First, what selectors? Selectors is used to create a link between the what HTML and the browser. It will create a link, so it will guide the what for the browser. So what it should do, right? So what pattern in the web page, right? In the web page, after compiling all these things, how it should display, how that particular tag should display, how the particular selector should display, right? That is what the role of selectors. Next, as I said, property, you know, right? Property, as I explained, what it should do. Okay, for that particular tag, what it should do, that will be explained by this property. For this H1, you have to do this. That is what the property here, background color. For H1, you have to do the background color. That is what the property. Next, right? Then value. This property may be like here, background color we have given. Instead of background color, we can use the writer. Fonts also we can use. Font means here, in place of background color, I want to make this as font size. Font size. This is also one of the property we can use for H1. Font size, here the value should be appropriate. It is not appropriate. Font size. Okay, for font size, if I give the value as red, it will not perform. Okay, size means we have to give some value there, right? Font size should be like 2 or 3, right? 2 or 3, like that we have to give the font size, right? So what it indicating here, according to the property, the value should be also matching to that one, right? Here property is background color. If background color, I give the value like 2 or 3, means what is the meaning for that one? So it will be confusing for the browser that what it will do, it will ignore. It will not perform the task only. Okay, it will not perform that background color or font size equal to 5, 10. For 5, 10 means it will perform for that H1, whatever the text is there, it will give the size like 5. Right, it will give the 5 as the size there. Right, so what's the property? So value should be appropriate to that property, then only it will perform. Right, so value is like declaration, right? Value is nothing but a declaration. So for this property, you have to perform this value. Means you are performing background color. For that color should be like red, green, like that. Okay, that is what the syntax here. CSS syntax. So CSS syntax includes selectors followed with a property followed with a value. If you want to give the another property, semicolon or next property, then value. If you want to do one more property, again semicolon, next property. That is what the CSS syntax. Okay.